So this technique is a dynamic tape power band technique for patellofemoral pain syndrome or patellofemoral joint dysfunction, where we're suggesting that the weak, inhibited, delayed medially through their vastus medialis obliquus and relatively tight laterally, such that we're getting this tracking of the patella laterally. So we're going to use our power band, which is made by laminating two layers of 2-inch or 5-centimeter dynamic tape together. We're going to use that to provide a sling and therefore some resistance to lateral translation of the patella. So you may have done this with our traditional technique, just using one strip of dynamic tape, but this just gives us a little bit more force, or more resistance to that lateral translation as well. So really what we're trying to do is basically create a tight band with the patella wedged in the middle so that we have this force resisting it moving laterally. In order to do that, we generally start over about the lateral third of the patella, and then we place our medial glide onto the patella and we sweep around medially both at the inferior end, maintain our glide, and then sweep through again superiorly and then up onto the VM or even onto the adductors to pick up that fascial sling. Okay. Now, here's a power band that we made earlier. Again, with these hollow areas, generally suggest you use a spray if you have one, or just make sure that you do hold it down very well afterwards and allow adequate time for it to bond. You can also, with this technique, start distally and just sweep all the way up, and I certainly know that some people find the handling a little easier to start here. Just make sure though that as you do that, you do get your nice glide immediately as you come up, and again, that gives you that straight line with this resistance to lateral translation, which of course when they bend up is going to tighten up, and that's where we get this increase in our resistance to lateral translation of that patella. In this demonstration though, I'll start on the patella itself. So just tear your tape a little bit away from the end this time, because we're going to start on the patella and try and pick up about that lateral third of the patella. If you start too anteriorly, the tape's going to run very much down the front. We'll give you some nice load absorption into knee flexion extension, but won't provide a resistive force to lateral translation. Similarly, if you come too lateral, you won't actually be in contact with the patella at all, so you won't be getting any resistance to lateral translation. So generally pick up around about the lateral third of the patella, and that becomes your anchor point. Just hold that for a few seconds first, just to get that glue bonding. Then place a medial glide on the patella. Remember, you don't need a great deal of stretch, and there is a lot more resistance with these power bands. So place your stretch on gently, and then leave a nice anchor point at the bottom that has no stretch on it. Hold that for a few seconds as well. Then come to your top end, and we're going to do the same thing. So place our medial glide on, maintain your medial glide. I find this is easiest with your thumb of the bottom hand, and then swoop your fingers around to smooth that down, running that up medially, and then again have the last inch or so, a couple of inches, without any tension on that tape. Give this a nice hold on the ends to get that glue bonding well. Now again, because of the increased strength in these, they're generally recommended as a short duration wear time, several hours, a match, a training session, perhaps up to half a day or so. If you are leaving it on longer, and you certainly can do that, but you do need to take great care that you don't apply very much tension through there. The position, once again, is going to create the tension as they bend. That's where our tension is. You can see how that's going to then hook in under this lateral aspect of the patella. Now, as we then come to put our cover strip on, give a light spray to the underneath layer just to get a good adhesion once again. Again, I generally start with this over the patella itself, but you can start from the bottom and work your way up, so perhaps we'll do that for this demonstration. So this will provide a third layer now. Just make sure that you're anchoring to skin and that you're covering the power band completely with about a half an inch or 1 1/4 centimeters on either side to secure that to the skin. That will make sure that you only have one layer of tape as an edge in contact with the skin, which means that it's much less likely to lift up than if you have three or four layers, which will give you a much thicker edge, obviously. So, once again, sweep up. Now, as we come to the patella, you need to be placing that medial glide on once again, and then sweep around. Make sure you're covering the tape on all sides, the power band that is. Now, because this sits anterior to the axis of the knee joint as well, it is going to stretch when they go into flexion and recoil as they come back into extension. So it is going to do some of that load absorption through your quad patellofemoral joint, patella tendon, muscular tendinous unit as well. So that in itself can take some load away potentially from that patellofemoral joint. But as we bend up, this is going to hook in under the outside, resist that lateral motion of the patella. So here we can see how the dynamic tape will absorb load in flexion and then reintroduce that back into extension. Because of the lateral positioning of the power band in particular, it will tension under flexion and resist lateral translation.